Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. In this video, we'll do some STP tuning, following the same examples as in the lecture video. We'll modify bridge priority, port cost, and port priority to control the STP topology in this LAN. Let's get started with step 1, which says to modify bridge priority to achieve the following. Switch 1 should be the root bridge for VLAN 10 and the secondary root for VLAN 20, and vice versa for switch 2. It should be the root for VLAN 20 and secondary for VLAN 10. So I'll go on switch 1 first. Let's check the current status for VLAN 10. Enable, show spanning tree VLAN 10. So switch 1 is not the root bridge. As you can see, the root ID and bridge ID here are different. Note that if you load the lab into CML, it might be different for you, because these MAC addresses are random. Anyway, to make switch 1 the root, I could use the spanning tree VLAN 10 root primary command, but as I mentioned in the lecture video, that's not the recommended method. Instead, I'll just set switch 1's priority to 0. Conf t, spanning tree VLAN 10, priority 0. So that should ensure that switch 1 is the root for VLAN 10. Let's double check. Do show spanning tree VLAN 10. Indeed, this bridge is the root, and all ports are designated. To ensure that switch 2 becomes the root for VLAN 10 if switch 1 goes down, let's make it the secondary root. Enable, conf t. Now, since I'm leaving switch 3 and switch 4 at the default priority values, I could just use spanning tree VLAN 10 root secondary, but I'll follow best practice and use the priority command. Let's set it to 4096, like in the lecture video. Spanning tree VLAN 10, priority 4096. Okay, that's VLAN 10. Now I'll do the opposite for VLAN 20. Let's make switch 2 the root. Spanning tree VLAN 20, priority 0. And I'll double check. Do show spanning tree VLAN 20. Indeed, switch 2 is the root bridge for VLAN 20, with all designated ports. To finish up step 1, let's go back to switch 1 and make it the secondary root for VLAN 20. Spanning tree VLAN 20, priority 4096. Okay, let's return to the lab notes. We have completed step 1. Switch 1 is the root for VLAN 10 and secondary for VLAN 20, and vice versa for switch 2. Now let's do step 2. It says to modify port cost to achieve the following. In VLAN 10, all traffic from users connected to switch 4 should pass through switch 2 before reaching the root bridge. And then the same thing for VLAN 20. Traffic from users connected to switch 3 should pass through switch 1. So let's do VLAN 10 first. I'll go on switch 4. Enable, show spanning tree VLAN 10. So because switch 1 is the root bridge for VLAN 10, and switch 4 G01 is directly connected to it, G01 is switch 4's root port. To make switch 4 send frames through switch 2, we should modify G01's port cost to influence switch 4's root port selection process. Switch 4's root cost via G01 is 4, just the cost of G01 itself. Its cost via G00 is 8, 4 for G00, plus 4 for switch 2 G00. So to make switch 4 select G00, let's make G01's cost greater than 8. Conf t, interface G01, I'll make it the same as a fast Ethernet link, 19. Spanning tree VLAN 10, cost 19. So now that G01 has a higher cost, switch 4 should make G00 its root port. Let's check. Do show spanning tree VLAN 10. As expected, switch 4 has selected G00. So we've finished the task for VLAN 10. Traffic from users connected to switch 4 will pass through switch 2. Now let's do VLAN 20. Traffic from users connected to switch 3 should pass through switch 1. Let's check the current status of switch 3. Enable, show spanning tree VLAN 20. Just like before on switch 4, Switch 3 selected G01 as its root port. Let's do the same thing as on Switch 4. I'll increase the cost of G01 to make Switch 3 select G00 as its root port. Conf T, interface G01, spanning tree VLAN 20, cost 19. Now let's check. Do show spanning tree VLAN 20. So Switch 3 has now selected G00 as its root port instead of G01. Let's go back to the lab notes. So we have completed step 2. Step 3 says to modify port priority to ensure that frames forwarded between Switch 1 and Switch 2 use the G01 to G01 link in both VLANs 10 and 20. So let's do VLAN 10 first. Switch 1 is the root bridge, so both of its ports are designated in a forwarding state. It's Switch 2 that determines which link is actually used, the link connecting their G00 ports, or the link connecting their G01 ports. Let's go back on Switch 2. I'll check VLAN 10. Do show spanning tree VLAN 10. So it selected G00 as its root port, because it's connected to a lower port ID on Switch 1. So we have to make Switch 2 select G01 as its root port. How can we do that? There are two methods. We can make Switch 1 G00 less preferable by increasing its port priority, or make Switch 1 G01 more preferable by decreasing its priority. I'll do what I did in the lecture video. Make Switch 1 G00 less preferable. So let's return to Switch 1. Interface G00. Let's increase its priority to the max, 240. Spanning tree VLAN 10, port priority 240. So by increasing G00's port priority, we have made it inferior to G01 from the perspective of the STP algorithm. As a result, Switch 2 should select G01 as its new root port, instead of G00. Let's return to Switch 2. Before we check, let me emphasize that it's the neighbor port ID that is the deciding factor here, not the port ID of Switch 2's own ports. So let's see if Switch 2 selected a new root port. Do show spanning tree VLAN 10. As expected, G01 is Switch 2's root port now, not G00. Now we'll do the same for VLAN 20. Switch 2 is the root bridge, so this time it's Switch 1's root port selection that determines which link is used for forwarding. Currently, it should be G00, but let's confirm. I'll return to Switch 1, and let's check. Do show spanning tree VLAN 20. Indeed, Switch 1 has selected G00, not G01, as its root port. That's because G00 is connected to a lower port ID on Switch 2. So once again, there are two choices. Make Switch 2 G00 less preferable, or make Switch 2 G01 more preferable. I'll do the latter. Let's return to Switch 2. So I'll lower G01's priority to 0. Interface G01, spanning tree VLAN 20, port priority 0. 0 is the lowest port priority, and therefore the most preferable. So Switch 1 should select G01 as its new root port. Before we check, let me point out that the port priority can only be configured in increments of 16. For example, I can't do spanning tree VLAN 20 port priority 1. I didn't mention that in the lecture video, so just pointing it out. Okay, let's return to Switch 1 and check its root port. Do show spanning tree VLAN 20. Okay, Switch 1 has selected G01 as its root port. So we have finished step 3. In both VLANs 10 and 20, frames forwarded between Switch 1 and Switch 2 will use the G01 link, not the G00 link. Okay, that's all for the lab and this video. When it comes to STP tuning, usually selecting a root bridge and a secondary root bridge is sufficient. But you might encounter some cases where the network requirements need you to do a bit of extra tuning like this. Plus, it's definitely something you could be asked on the ENCOR exam. Okay, I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Velva Jacob, Funny Dart, George, Nasir Chowdhury, Gustavo B.R., Marcel Lord, Pavel M., Dragos Hernea, Zakib Shah, Mara Salman, Vitaus 194, Gina Lindley, Mark Jackson, Bold 1C1U, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Hector Hernandez, Mara Tuba, Roji Kuriakos, Arpad Konivez, 5 Feet, Owad Daniel Brown, Jose Alvarez, Hussein Yavuz, Kevin Hayes, Samuel Tavares, Roger Bratseth, Mustafa Ersoy, Nasser Zahar, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemejev, Kyle, Arlen Plagaria, Dear Diso, Adelson Pereira, Farad 69, Joyce Njoroge, Lucien Stoichitoyu, Madmark 50484, Sean Powell, Alexander Stratan, Hiago Bicalho, Pieter Kaimov, Abdo Zizo, DMJ2, Kurt Nell, Omid Farakesh, Steve Cox, Jasper Yim, Wilmer Romero, Enigma G, Laurent Lam, Pedro Hartman, Ivano Capuano, Jefferson Steelflex, Alejandra Okana, Burl Campbell, Abhishek Sahu, Toxic, Sinan Sarisinar, Gio, Daniel Andrade, Jairo Francisco, Mike Crumby, Eliel Eliluli, Dragos George, Anas Hajaj, and Sarmad S. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So, if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.